Hello, good morning, and it is time for some more RDNA 2. Today I'm going to be going over my results for the 6700 XT, and I know, I didn't stream this one live because AMD just takes forever, so eventually I will get back to live streaming these as I test them, but I ended up spending 4 hours tuning this card from my couch, so anyway, that's why you didn't see a stream and you're now seeing a recap. I did use a reference design card. You can see that up here on the top, along with the testing date and everything else that's relevant to the test. Samsung memory, not a particularly special bin, and that became actually quite apparent as I started working with things like Ergo. So anyway, here is the list, and we'll start with Flux, as I always do, just because this algorithm gives me a really good sense of working the memory and the core a little bit, how they're going to respond to undervolting, and then how they respond to transient power spikes as well with the lowered clocks. So we see here the best hash rate I was able to observe with these clocks was 40.6 sols. Efficiency wasn't particularly great doing that though. However, if we backed it down to 32 sols, the efficiency turned into tremendously good. We were using Mini Z for this entire test. I have found recently that it is working better than LOL Miner, even on AMD cards, which is kind of wild. Back in the day, that was kind of the reversal. But yeah, 0.509 efficiency is actually quite good on Equihash 125.4. Nexa, the hash rate's pretty unimpressive, so is the efficiency, so I would just leave Nexa with these. Dynex, hash rates, again, the miners are kind of all over the place right now. There's still a lot of optimization left on the table, I think, for these cards. So the hash rate's pretty underwhelming. The efficiency is good, but not great. So 40 hash to watt. Kyla coin, I don't really have enough data on this to really tell you if it's good or bad, but the efficiency is not very good. So I would leave Kyla. Alephium, reasonable. I would love to see a little bit more hash rate just with this class of card, but the core isn't quite as strong as like a 3070 core, so this kind of makes sense. Efficiency, all along the same lines. Where are we? 14.616. So it's borderline good. I think I have it set to 17. It actually used to be 15. So it's okay. I actually am, as you saw earlier, I'm mining Alephium on mine, so it still can make sense, especially if you're one of those miners that chases profits. Ironfish, I don't really know on hash rate. Again, I don't mine it regularly. The efficiency is reasonable. Again, 150 is kind of where I'd like to see it, and we're at 110, so... Radiant, the hash rate is disappointing, man. This is only like 1.5 P106s worth of hash rate, and the efficiency is just not that great either. I'd like to see 10 or better on efficiency there for Radiant, so a little disappointing. I thought these were going to be better at most of the core algos. And then we come up to Karlsen, which is basically, you know, the old Caspa hash. I think with Blake3 instead of SHA512, but this is quite good. So the hash rate, it's a little underwhelming, but it's still like double that of a P106. So I mean, it's still okay, and the efficiency is really pretty good. So we're getting 10 mega hash to watt or hash to watt, and I think the cutoff for me is 7 or 8. It's 8 actually. Ergo, 89.21. So the hash rate's pretty okay. In order to get good efficiency, I had to, like I said, spend a lot of time with this card because Ergo works the card just very, very differently. It's a pretty low power algo, but it hits the card really aggressively. So it's hard to explain, but there's a lot of very simple requests instead of, you know, very few very intensive requests. So Ergo is kind of wild, and I'm very curious to see how Fish Hash will end up working because it does incorporate elements of AutolykosV2, which is what Ergo uses. But we did ultimately observe 0.9090 efficiency at 80 mega hash, which is okay. And then you can see a third clock down here. I ended up remote tuning a friend of mine's rigs with 6700 XTs, and actually two of the cards ultimately ended up needing a ton more voltage. Excuse me, so I would maybe start with this garbage clock and work your way down in the voltages, but I think I do recommend just running 1125 as your core clock and starting with 725. There's quite a bit of hash rate loss, and it doesn't seem to be much more efficient if you drop the core clock. So anyway, your mileage may vary. I know Ergo's not a very popular coin for right now, but ETC, Pretty good. 47 mega hash, 0.479 hard efficiency. Pretty solid, pretty solid. Pigeon, bad hash rate, bad efficiency. I don't know why, man. Almost nothing is good at Pigeon. And then KawPow. These really shine at KawPow. So 24.69 was the best we saw hash rate wise, but that was at 0.209, which is only a little bit better. It's only like 10% better than a 5700 XT for efficiency. But if we drop it to 22.5 mega hash, we get up to 0.233. So yes, everything you've heard is correct. These are KawPow monsters. So that is insanely good efficiency. And I should be mining KawPow on mine, but I just don't have the power to do it right now. So anyway, that is the wrap-up sheet for the 6700 XT. Hopefully that helps you get a good baseline for your OCs. Again, I should say this every time, but these are not the gospel. They're not going to work on every card. They're probably not going to work on a Micron memory card, but it's better than hashrate.no, and I'm giving you real hardware power numbers, not software. So anyway, I will come back with another card, probably the 6800 XL next week. No promises on what it will be, but I will see you next Sunday. Thanks for watching.